Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel, Cooking with J.A.M's Gear. Today is going to be something special right here. You wouldn't believe what this is. Believe it or not, this is watermelon rind. Yes, watermelon. So basically, I got some watermelon. I ate the pink part. I peeled off the skin. A little bit of the pink watermelon still on left. I had added some curry powder up in here. Let me see if I can find the curry that I was using. So I used this Irie curry powder. I added in some salt, black pepper, and then I added in some of my homemade pepper sauce. You can see the video. So I'm gonna get ready. I'm gonna have my skillet here warming up with a little tablespoon of oil. Then I got some rice on to the side, some white rice. So let's get this ready. A few things I wanna get ready. I wanna get some onion and tomato ready. So stay tuned. All right, folks. Now that I got my skillet ready and the rest of my stuff, I'm gonna add in 4 cloves of garlic. Then some onion, white onion, half a white onion. Give this a mix. Rice here bubbling down. Got that on some low heat. To fire down some. So I'm just gonna saute this a little bit. Then I'm gonna add in my seasoned watermelon rind. So this actually been sitting in the fridge for actually 2 days. I was supposed to do this yesterday, but I ended up going out for dinner. So that 2 days gave it a nice, good marinade. So, rice. Burner's kind of hot. All right. So, I'm going to saute this, let this cook on medium heat. Stir it around. It's almost like zucchini. Stir that around for a bit. I'm gonna add in some green onion. Then I'm gonna add in some tomato. Mix that up. I'm not gonna add any water as yet. As you know, watermelon does retain a lot of water. Never made this before. I got this idea from my mom, and when she first told me about it, I was like, ew, curried watermelon. But then I tried it, this big chunk out of here, and then I'm like, wow, I'm a fan. So this is gonna be like my kind of like recipe, my spin on it. So I'm gonna let this sit here, simmer on the little medium heat for a bit, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'll let it went for 2 minutes. It's boiling down nice. Just gonna add in half a cup of water just to get things soften up. Stir it in there. I'm gonna add in some salt. Just a little bit. And then I'm gonna add in some of my homemade pepper. Cause you know I like spice. I need a new tripod, so I'm trying to do this with one hand or a phone holder so everything goes off whack. So the sauce is looking nice and thick. My rice is ready, burnt it. I think my stove is not working so good because on low heat this thing is blazing. Going all right. I'm gonna add in a little bit of the Iri curry powder. Get some out of here. Then I'm gonna mix it up. I guess this could be a vegan dish. This has no animal byproduct in here. It's actually looking pretty good. This is the first time I'm doing this. I'm gonna take a piece of this to see what it's going on like. It's still a little firm. Not bad. It's almost like a zucchini or a choco. Very nice, very spicy. I do think I'm gonna add a little bit more salt. It is on a little bit of the fresh side. So I had this marinating for 2 days with the Iri curry powder, some salt, black pepper, and some of my homemade sauce. Wasn't sure about the measurements, but so far this is going out good. Into this pot I added some pressed garlic, some half an onion, a whole tomato, about 5 spring onion, scallion if you want to call it, kind of like how the sauce is thickening. So I'm just going to cover this and let it, I'm going to put it on about medium low and let it go for about 5 minutes and then I'll be back. All right, now we're back. Turned off the fire, letting this simmer down. Stirred it a couple of bits. I tasted a few pieces. It's really delicious. I do find if you get close to the green part of the skin, it could be hard. But you can let it boil down to your tenderness. Right now, this is like texture of a firm zucchini. And I gotta say, I'm pretty impressed. The watermelon does hold a lot of the flavor. It does carry the flavor very well. You won't even taste the watermelon in it. I like how my sauce is nice and thick. I'm just gonna have this on some rice and give it a go. So I'm gonna plate this up and be right back.
Here we are with the finishing dish. Just made a little bowl with some rice. So this is it, folks. Curried watermelon rind and white rice. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do try this recipe, let me know how you think about it. Please like, comment, subscribe, share, and peace until next time.